more than 10 years ago, the SSA program has been created in ESA, and its prime goal was to put up the technology required to monitor space debris, space weather, and dangerous asteroids. Now, since the past year, we have established the Space Safety Program, which goes a step further. It will endorse what has been done in the Space SSA program, and it will continue monitoring and develop the technology we need for that. But it will go further and not only monitor, but also mitigate and prevent the risk. So space debris, the risk of being hit by artificial objects, that can be prevented by using the right technology on board of spacecraft and by even removing. Space weather can be forecasted and damages can be prevented if warnings come in timely. And asteroids, perhaps the first life form on Earth, that's us, that can prevent actually an impact of an asteroid on ground or provide timely warnings. The astronaut, the dinosaurs didn't have that possibility. So we are probably the first that can bring out technology in the space safety program that can actually prevent the risk from asteroids. So that is the difference. We are not only monitoring, we are also preventing the risk. The Artios mission will be the first ever mission to remove a piece of space debris. We are convinced that we will have to systematically do such kind of removals in the future. And these removals might be paid by industrial customers. So there's a market for these cases. ESA's role would be to help our industry and our member states, in particular Poland, who has done a significant subscription to Artios, in de-risking and bringing this over the hill in order for this to become operational outside ESA in the future. And thanks to the significant contribution for Poland, it will be possible to engage companies from Poland into this. There's a strong heritage in Poland in building mechanics for example, robotics arms. And that is important because we do not always want to remove debris, but in a later step, we might also want to repair or to refuel a defunct space object. And that requires the means for manipulation, and therefore mechanics are very important. So there's a good chance that the Polish entities can play a big role in the mechanics of the system. But not only, there are other opportunities in Artios. We still consider these three, space weather, space debris, and planetary defense, as the major hazards for our infrastructure and humanity, which we need to be prevented with space safety. The difference is that we are not only providing warnings in space safety, but we will actually cancel the risk. We will actually prevent these events from happening. That is our ambitious goal. When you look at space weather, 16 billion of euros are lost in our economy just due to moderate space weather events in the next years. This is something you can prevent when you have timely warnings. We will be risking our infrastructure in space due to space debris. We need to remove it, not only watch it, we need to remove it. And that is the added value it brings. Planetary defense, we have been watching asteroids for a long time. Now we can prevent them from actually hitting Earth. So we need to make this bold move. It is these three risks that remain in space safety, but we take it to the next level. We will actually remove them, these risks. With the example of large constellations, the three risk areas come together. Now, the large constellations, they're using space and they will be vulnerable to the space weather. They will add to our infrastructure because it will be very comfortable to have broadband internet everywhere in the world, but they are vulnerable to space weather. Large space weather event can disrupt this communication. And if it provides life critical services, for example, for autonomous driving or so on, you need to have space weather warnings in order to make sure of this. So this is number one. Then the constellation itself brings a massive amount of satellites into space. We are talking about numbers higher than what humanity has launched altogether in the past 60 years of space flight. We were launching in the next few years. And we have been bad in preventing debris in the past. Now, will these constellations be better? We don't know. We better provide the technology they need on board to make sure they do not contribute to the space debris problem. And that is the technology we will be developing in the space safety program, including the technology to remove one of them if we have to. And then, these last constellations are also an interesting aspect for space traffic, because today you can use space as you want. You don't have, there are no rules or norms of behavior. If so many active satellites are in space, we would also need to have to start and coordinating among each other. And that is technology you will see from the space safety program as well. I think that in a few years, you can expect not only a weather forecast, but also a space weather forecast. You can get a downstream product, for example, dedicated to aviation or dedicated to landlines or even dedicated to spaceflight, that where you can register and you get timely warnings that concern your asset, and you switch off your asset in time in order not to risk any damage for space weather. So this will be very concrete output on the downstream for everybody in the end. Planetary defense, already now you can look up on our web pages daily warning, updated warning lists for several thousand asteroids, how close they come to Earth, how likely is an impact on Earth. That will be a downstream product available to everybody, but mainly, of course, to alert centers that we need to make sure that the right action is taken. And on space debris, we will see concrete products that will help to manage traffic. So as a space operator, you will be equipped with solutions where you can hands off rely on automated features to help mitigating collisions, preventing collisions by coordinating with other objects, by making sure that you have an automated processing behind, and you don't need a team of experts being awake around the clock to watch collision avoidance warnings, because they're getting many. ESA is an operator of spacecraft, and we are receiving hundreds of warnings in a day. That is getting unmanageable, and therefore we need products that help us managing this huge amount of data and coordinating this in the right way.